order to earn your white belt, you have to know three things. You have to know how to hold your instrument, how to make a sound with your right hand, and how to change pitch with your left hand. In order to play cello, you're going to need something to sit on. Oftentimes, cellos will sit in slightly lower chairs than they would normally sit in. Make sure that your chair has no arms and no wheels so that you can play well. A tiny chair-sized stool can work well, too. Usually, you won't sit all the way back in your chair because you might scrape the back of your cello. And also, you want to be able to move around freely while playing. Once you have a chair, you'll raise your cello up to the right height by adjusting the end pin and pulling it in or out. Make sure that you tighten the screw all the way so that your end pin doesn't go back inside your instrument. Everybody's body is a different size and shape, so how we hold our instrument changes a little bit from person to person. These are the four things to look for to know that you have good posture. The first and most important is your bow. You should be able to drop your bow down and have it land straight in the middle of the space between the fingerboard and the bridge. Notice that my arm isn't straightened all the way out, it's curved in a relaxed manner. You can try this, but since we haven't learned how to hold the bow yet, let's move on to number two. The back of your instrument should rest comfortably on your chest. If it's digging in uncomfortably, then experiment with changing around the position or the height of the end pin until it's comfortable. If you have a hard time finding a spot that's comfortable, ask me in class. It's a lot easier to show in person than to describe on a video. The third thing to check is that the neck of the cello is going past your neck. Your cello might be lower towards your shoulder or higher towards your ear, depending on how high your chest pushes the cello up. You probably won't be able to see your fingertips if you're holding your cello correctly. When we play songs, you can check your finger position before we start, move back into good posture for the song, and then at the end, check to see if your fingers have moved off the tapes. The fourth and last thing to check is that this point of the lower bout should be above your knee on both sides. We don't want the point of the cello to jab into your skin. If the rest of the cello fits you well, but this point is down low, it probably means that your cello is too big. Cellists hold their cellos almost flat against their chests. If you're playing on the A string for a long time, though, sometimes we'll turn the cello in a little bit. We control this angle with our left knee. Okay, so here's how to get your cello into position. Start with your feet flat and your knees spread apart a little bit. Days when you're going to play cello, it's best not to wear a skirt or a kilt. Put your cello vertical, a little ways in front of you. Put your left hand around the base of the neck and draw it around and up until it's in position. You should be able to hold it between your legs, the floor, and your chest. We're going to hold the cello the same, regardless of whether you're left or right-handed, so make sure that the instrument's neck is to the left of your neck. If you're playing on a hard floor and need a rock stop to keep your cello from sliding away, this point on the floor is where you're going to line up your rock stop. Okay, now let's talk about the size of your instrument. The most important thing for sizing is that your fingers can reach each of the tapes. If you have to stretch so much just to reach that your hands are really tense and they start turning colors, you should go down a size. The next thing to check is the size of the body of the instrument. If you can't have both the lower bout above your knee and the upper part of the back on your chest, then it may be too big. If you suspect this is the case, ask me in class. Also important is the length of your end pin. Some people are really tall but have short fingers. When this is the case, they need a small instrument with a long end pin to hold it off the floor. If your end pin doesn't seem to be long enough, ask me in person, and we may have you ask the music store for a longer end pin. Now that you've learned how to hold your cello and how to tell if it's the right size, you're ready to hear about the number one thing that will affect your playing, and that is relaxation. If your body is tense while playing, your sound will be very tense, and the listeners will feel the stress. Relaxation starts at your feet and moves up your body. Make sure that your feet are flat on the floor and that you're able to wiggle them. Make sure your back is strong and tall. But note that if you're tense like a soldier, you've gone too far. Roll your shoulders around and let them drop. Can you sway back and forth while holding your cello? All right, continue on to part 2 to learn how to make a sound.